Hey, what's up guys? This is YTB here and welcome back to the whole new episode of What Public Says. Yes, hashtag WPS. And in this episode, we'll be just uploading a video every week where we and our crew members will be just going to the busy streets as malls, restaurants, parks, theaters, anywhere, beaches, anywhere. We'll be just going to the public and we will be just collecting the public retention. Yes. So in these episodes, we'll be just going to the public places and just collect the information from the public and what they think actually about a smartphone should be. Yes. So these videos will be helpful for all the brand companies who are ready to hear from their consumers how a smartphone should be. And in case this is your first time visit to this channel, hey guys, I'm Dhanashekaran here and you're watching me on my YouTube channel, Your Tech Bro. Make sure you subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon nearby. And in case you end up liking this video, make sure hit the like button. So we have done a few hard work. I hope so. Damn. Okay, hi.
Hey.
What's your name?
Asher.
Okay. So, which smartphone brand do you prefer?
I like Redmi, so I prefer Redmi.
So, you prefer MI, right?
Yeah.
Is there any particular reason for choosing MI?
So, camera quality is nice and they are providing good RAM and ROM.
Okay. That's right. So, generally budget-oriented devices,
yes,
right?
Budget-oriented.
So, easy for mostly all people to just buy this device.
Certainly.
Samsung.
Any particular reason for Samsung?
Samsung is good, looks good and features are good.
Okay, features are good. You love the features, okay. Design-wise?
Design-wise also good.
You get S7, 8 screen, all those dual notches, okay.
Basically, we prefer Samsung.
Samsung.
Yeah.
Is there any particular reason for Samsung?
Samsung, I'm using this for more than 4 years.
You're using Samsung for more than 4 years. And you know the model?
Samsung Grand 2.
It's Grand 2.
I have Lenovo,
yeah.
So I prefer going for Samsung or something, Redmi.
Okay, you prefer Samsung or Redmi?
Yeah, most probably.
Just come up with one.
Redmi, I think, because.
Okay, Redmi.
I use, but I heard like it is better.
Okay, you heard that Redmi is somewhat better, okay.
Well, I prefer Apple.
You prefer Apple? Wow, at least one I got Apple, okay. But is there any particular reason for choosing Apple?
Because of its speed. And definitely a huge storage space and a great camera.
I think Android is also having those qualities that you say, right?
But still, I prefer Apple because it's an all-rounder.
Okay, that's good. That's really good.
Okay. As of now, I prefer OnePlus.
OnePlus. Is there any particular reason for OnePlus?
The reason is like they are, you know, using the latest technologies and also they're selling the phones with a very competitive market price. That's the main preference I prefer always.
That's really good.
Myself prefer for iPhone.
Okay.
The very important thing in iPhone is very secure and also, you know, it's user friendly. Even though people will prefer for other phones will be user friendly, but I prefer it's for iPhone, it's user friendly for me.
Okay, good.
Same iPhone.
iPhone. Any reason?
Because security purpose.
Security purpose. Okay.
Basically, according to myself, I prefer budget phones.
Okay, you prefer budget phones.
Yeah.
Is there any particular reason for budget phones?
Because my usage, according to my usage, it's enough for me with the budget.
Okay, phone. It just comes up with harsh usages.
Yeah.
Okay. User?
Yes, budget phones.
Any reason?
Having the children, you can't go for high-end.
That's a good reason. Okay. Budget devices versus flagship and versus mid-range.
I prefer mid-range.
Okay, mid-range.
Because mid-range phone provides, this is budget-friendly.
Okay.
And it provides what we need is providing.
Okay, it just provides all the day-to-day usages, right?
Flagship usage, they're providing more memory or something else, more camera quality, but it's a flagship mobile now. We have to spend more.
Yeah, nowadays all the features of flagship just comes under budget oriented, all the mid range devices. So many people are not opting for
flagship. That's why I'm preferring Redmi, because they are providing Redmi A1 at 50,000, 15,000 rupees and Redmi Mix 2 at 22,000, 30,000 rupees. That's why I'm preferring Redmi.
I think budget phones are enough.
Budget phones. Is there any strong reason for budget phones?
Actually, Being a software engineer, I won't get much time for...
Oh, you're a software engineer. Wow, superb.
So I won't get much time to use all the features available. I just need for the navigation and call and WhatsApp. So for that, I think budget phone is enough.
I prefer budget phone. The reason I said Redmi, right? In a budget, they give better specifications. So between mid-range or budget, that'll be toss-up.
I would prefer mid-range because it gives everything comparatively to the other versions.
Why not flagship?
Out of budget.
Obviously flagship phone, because they'll be try to cope up with the new technology, whatever is in the market. Because the mid-range mobiles, it'll be good for only when you compare with the price range, it'll be better. But flagship phone, since we are into the technology part, so obviously the flagship phone, which is having the latest technology, I'll always prefer.
Okay, that's good. In my views, I can go for a mid-range phone because I'm not, that much into one technology and using it. So myself, I prefer the mid-range phones.
Okay.
Flagship phones.
Flagship. Any particular reason for flagship?
Just for new technologies.
Just for new technologies.
I think Android is fine.
Particular reason?
Yeah, iOS is too costly, right?
Even Apple SE is also cheaper, right, nowadays? It comes around 23,000.
It is like old model, right?
Okay, you're saying that somewhat 10 years back,
yeah.
Why it's coming right now? Okay, you're choosing Android. Android versus iOS.
I like Android because it's user-friendly.
Why not iOS?
iOS, some features like iTunes, we have to download the iTunes, so they're asking for permission or something. But the Android, there's no legal issues with it.
Yeah. Play Store is one of the major advantages of Android.
Everything is available in the Play Store.
Okay. Android versus iOS.
Yeah, I prefer Android, sir.
Android.
Yeah.
Okay. Any two reasons for preferring Android?
Actually, I'm familiar with Android. I'm not familiar with the.
Okay. Android may be customizable, whereas iOS cannot be.
Yeah, user friendly, as my friend said. It's user friendly.
Yes, Android is very, very user-friendly.
Yeah.
So, how are you familiar with Samsung right now?
Android, and it is very user-friendly. All features are very, very user-friendly. I don't like Apple.
Okay, you don't like Apple.
Yeah, it is better than the Apple.
And iOS I have not used, but I feel like, iOS stands for, another brand. If you carry that, if you're using iOS, right? Carry that, that's a brand. And I will go for probably, if I have option to go for, definitely, I have budget, then I'll go for iOS then.
Any good thing you heard about iOS from rather than Android?
Yeah, iOS, they are very classic. They won't deviate from their design much. So that's the classiness, and they hold the value like this. So, and the smoothness, and the camera even, they have the, old phone of iOS, right? 4 or something.
3GS.
3GS. So they have 500 RAMs, but they run lot of, complex games. So that's the quality. That's the quality. So I should go for iOS.
iOS, definitely.
Okay, that's good.
Yeah, that's a...
That's a long time debate, right?
So, in my view, as Shiva mentioned, it is more secured. The iOS is more secured. And obviously, there won't be any virus impact on iOS, but Android will always have the problem. At the same time, even though it has, more secured reasons, I always prefer this Android because the reason is it's more compatible with the Windows and everything. If you go with the iPhone, you always have to, rely on spending more time even for transferring money.
That's going to be the same for most of the people there, I guess.
Of course,
you personally use the iPhone, right?
Yeah, I'll prefer iPhone. iPhone, iOS. I prefer the iOS. The only main reason isn't secure purpose. Also, if you take business work also, it'll be more easy for a good app and all. So I prefer iPhone.
He prefers the camera.
iOS.
You're buying a smartphone for fashion purpose or just real-time purpose?
I'm buying for fashionable.
For fashion?
I like sexy phones.
Then what's your mobile model?
MIA1.
MIA1.
From my point of view, we use basically for business point of view. We are using for the business purpose. And nowadays, all things regarding children, everything comes from our school, it comes
for real-time usage.
Real-time usage, okay. Fully real-time usage.
Okay. Not for like fashionable purposes.
For me, considering my usage, I would say like, you know, 80% for the usage and for 20% for fashionable, because I always, you know, try to move to the new technologies. It is only for the fashion, because, you know, the 80% will be the usage is going to be same, because whatever it is, you know, satisfying my need, it is going to be same. Even if I buy 6,000 or 7,000 mobile, the usage is going to be same. So that's my preference, 80-20%.
Okay. Yes.
It's again 80-20 ratio. 20 is for fashionable and 80 is for obviously it's a reasonable thing. And most preferably it will be, you know, we can update into our technology and it will be very user friendly also. We can utilize for our personal purpose as well as official purpose too.
Yes.
For me, it's not about fashion, it's about my usage.
Sometimes fashion and then.
Okay, both 50-50, 50% okay. Which Apple iPhone you are using right now?
Right now I'm having Apple 6s and it's definitely just for fashion.
Yeah, I know, does nothing, okay, because I too own a 6s, but the real-time use when compared to iPhone, Android, iPhone just lacks a bit. Do you accept it?
Surely.
Do you just accept your smartphone is not secure that much?
No, it is secure. Hey,
the reason I'm telling is iPhones are more secure than Android. Do you just
nowadays Android phones are also becoming secured. They have security.
Okay, you receive more security patch updates every month.
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Yeah, same here also.
Not really.
In what way?
Like even Mark Zuckerberg is not safe on Facebook. It's
everyone.
No, I don't you know, feel this. I have never seen this because I started with the Motorola, the first my, you know, the smartphone, and then moved to Samsung and also the LG, now into OnePlus 5. So all four brands, I never, you know, felt like you're cheated.
So which among the four you like the most?
OnePlus for sure.
OnePlus. Okay.
Before we, when we purchase the phone, we just always, you know, go for a reviews and we'll go all the specifications and features and all. So I personally prefer iPhone, so there won't be any cheating in that iPhone, even though it's there's some market issues happen, but still it was the every time the market again.
No, till now I used Sony and Motorola. They both got the specifications.
What they're telling outside is being present inside. Do you accept this word?
Yes.
Yeah.
But actually, we don't know, like, we have not gone through all the specifications, right? They'll be mentioning some gyro sensor, some lot of things, yeah, but
there are a lot of sensors for each sensor has unique purpose. So do you think that the specification that provides, that's being provided by Redmi is equal to a flagship device?
Not at all. You cannot expect, right?
Because Redmi also provides a 12 MP megapixel and Samsung high-end mobile also just, there are a lot of difference between their camera.
Definitely. Yeah, that's there. The thing is, like, if you see in a package, right, you won't see the camera alone. We see the processor, we see the RAM and all together, memory. So all together, I know Redmi, you know, comes for, you know, little higher.
Okay, what model you are using in Lenovo, right?
Lenovo A6000 Plus.
A6000.
And also Samsung Galaxy.
Okay, in case you are upgrading your device, to which device you'll be upgrading to the latest trend?
Latest Redmi, you know, Note 5 came, right?
Redmi 5.
Yeah, I think I should go for that.
That's really good. Because I've made review of the mobile, that's really good.
Review is also good. We always prefer review, I think. Without touching the mobile, you cannot predict, right?
Yeah, that's the real thing. Because they'll screw us.
Mention one thing here, if you compare with Android and iOS, you know, people, of course, you have to accept it. iPhone, you can charge it within 5 to 10 minutes.
Yeah.
Right? If you go for an Android, that's not practically possible.
Nowadays they introduce the technology quick charge.
But still it's not, you know, compatible with iOS. If you put a charge for 5 minutes, it will get into 40%.
So what about the backup?
That also would be very good in iOS. Backup is also
no. I don't really accept with this because, you know, as you said, Android.
So that also based on the user.
Yeah, user is one thing, and now competitively even OnePlus started, you know, giving the quick chargers.
Google Focus, yeah, yeah. iPhone.
Yeah.
So storage is not connected.
Yeah, you can use OneDrive.
Yeah. So there are so many brands, like, you know, Asus and the OnePlus is especially, and the other one like I think Oppo and all. Nowadays they, you know, it is a competitive market in mobile technologies now. Everyone started, I mean recently I've seen one mobile, it is having, you know, three camera. Earlier it was only
Honor,
one
Honor, and
then
20.
Yeah, so it then it became, the trend was like a dual camera, now it became three cameras. So maybe in future we'll have
that's
all
really a competitor for DSLRs, right?
Yeah, that's right, but no, nobody can, you know, beat the DSLR.
Yeah, nobody can beat a DSLR's clarity. That's, right. That's real. Like if you're just seeing your smartphone from a long distance, wow, he's having iPhone 10 that comes with the dual camera at the back, that's glossy finish. So for that purpose, or else real-time purpose for just using WhatsApp, Facebook, Instagram, like that.
I use for real-time purpose, but definitely you say, right, when you see someone using, you know, iOS, that perception will come.
Nowadays people used to judge the people based on their smartphone. Do you accept this?
I don't accept that.
Mostly this happens. Oh, he's having a costly mobile, he's come up, naturally he comes up as a very rich family.
Yeah, that is there. I mean, that's human perception, but you should understand, like, you know, wearing a nice shirt or a smartphone or watch, kind of, that won't define a person.